Well, week 14 is done, and the playoffs were set. And not one person was crying or wet. The stockings were all hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that the commissioner soon would be there. And Mama in her bed, and I in my... fuck it. Who cares? Fuck that. You guys, the playoffs are set. They were set, and there's no complaining. And anyone crying that they did their best?
Your best. Losers always whine about their best. Winners go home and fuck the prom queen.
In week 14, a rare win was saw by Sean's Red Hot Jabril Peppers, who turned up the heat and smoked my smelly punt the fifth. Oh my god. He beat me by nearly 35 points. But the fact that I only scored 65.38 points, the lowest score of the week, and the lowest score of all season, according to Statman, I heard, is the real reason Sean got the W. Because I suck.
You're pathetic.
Here's Sean to talk some mad shit from a forklift.
I forked you up bad, Pete. Piece of shit.
In another oddity of a matchup, Joe's Fuck You Pete the Fifth, Fuck You Joe, was actually defeated by Brent's Doing Pretty Shitty. He handed Joe his second, only his second loss of the season. And of course, Brent had some words for you, Joe.
Fuck you, Pete the Fifth. Fuck you, Joe. I got you. Finally. Now you know what it's like running backwards naked through the cornfield of doom. Yeah, you suck. I beat you. Even though I'm not making the playoffs, I still kicked your ass to make you go 12-2, not 13-1. So, yeah, I kind of made my season. Yep. Good luck, everybody. And also, always, as always, go fuck yourself.
Joe's record of 12-2 for the season, though, is actually a...
Stat of the day, dap, bap. Stat of the day. Here comes that what? Stat of the day. Bop.
Joe had the best record of any manager in all 5 seasons of the Fucknuts. Bravo, Joe. Bravo. My mom beat off Tark's team a lot. Wait a minute. John beat Todd? By the narrowest margin? So John wins the nail biter for the week of 14. Congrats, John. John actually had some deep thoughts about his win over Todd.
God, could you imagine if I had lost to Todd twice this year? The shame and embarrassment I would feel. Of course, we know that would never happen. But if it did, I would imagine that it would be something like this.
Superior to Todd. He sucks.
In the other matchups in week 14, George fed Rob a cup of pudding. Enjoy, Rob. Alex had the total domination award, beating Brendon by by 55.46 points. Looks like we made it. Left each other on the way to another love. Oh. Still don't have a winning record, though, do you, Alex?
I won! No, I won! No, I won!
Allen squeaked out a win by beating Jay by about 20 points. Wow. Congrats, Allen.
You are a loser.
Finally, Dave also managed to get a W by beating Jed by about 20 points. Wow. So the total domination was Alex. Rob gets another cup of pudding from George. The nail biter was won by John. And Brent had the highest score. And I had the lowest score. How'd Brent get the highest score, cornfucker? And I had the lowest score for the third time this season. And now, let's get right to the playoffs.
Time Life and the NFL present the Very Merry NFL Christmas Music Collection, with such Christmas favorites as The Carol of Le'Veon Bell.
Pass me the pot, shame, it's the cops, throw it away, out of our sleigh, sleigh filled with fear.
With 75 Christmas favorites on 3 compact discs, it would be a crime not to own this collection.
Grandma got run over by Dante Stallworth.
Away.
Featuring the NFL's most notorious Slee Mary players.
I saw baby mama kissing Santa Claus.
Aw, hell no.
Do you see what I see? A spy, filming.
Timeless classics for the first time ever in one collection.
Michael Irvin, the snowman, loves the finest cut cocaine.
And this charitable tribute to all NFL players whose careers have been affected by their domestic abuse charges.
Do they know it's domestic abuse at all?
It's a very merry NFL Christmas.
Danny the Redskin racist, you'll go down in bigotry.
Not sold in stores, these hits will leave your head ringing like an undiagnosed concussion.
Have yourself a merry little concussion.
For the unreasonable price of $99.99, no matter what the NFL does, they're still going to get your money.
Rogers' fines seem arbitrary. Stuffs his stockings with lots of money.
To order, call the number on your screen or send check or money order to Roger Goodell.
Let's start with the toilet bowl. John and Brent both get byes because we both know that, you know, they're both bye. And My Smelly Pump the Fifth went up against If You Ain't First, You're Last. So we got the byes over here. Those guys took a break, doing pretty shitty, and John's my mom. Pete Smelly Pump the Fifth went up against Rob's
If You Ain't First, You're Last.
We all know who that was going to go down. Rob, you're eliminated from the toilet bowl playoff, so no first pick for you next season. I'm sorry. But you do have Sherry's to look forward to. Congratulations on coming in last for second time in league history. Two-peat, just like Alex, just the opposite end of the spectrum. Sean's Red Hot Jabril Peppers did not beat off Tark's team a lot. So, Todd is the winner, while Sean is the loser.
Le who? The her.
Sean also scored the lowest amount of points for the second time this season and the second time ever in league history for him. So, Sean, another $5 in the kitty. I know you paid it. Good sport. Let's get to the real playoffs. Amazingly, Dave, the 8 seed, took out Joe's Fuck You Pete the 5th. Again, fuck you, Joe. So, Joe was eliminated from the championship putting Dave into the quarterfinals. Oh, of course, Joe has an excuse.
You know what? You may have beaten me, but I still have my mahogany library, my many leather-bound books, my gigantic cellar of booze. So I'm the fucking winner in life, and this is a shitty fucking league. Fuck you, and fuck everybody in it.
Alan fed George his own cup of pudding. So Alan won, knocked off George. He's going to eat his own cup of pudding, and that puts Alan here in the quarterfinals. Newbie Jed. Jed, congratulations. You obliterated two-time champion Alex. Oh, so Jed right here, McFeely Moose Knuckles, beat Jim Bob Cooter, making sure Alex didn't get into the playoffs. Sorry, Alex.
That makes you feel pretty dumb, doesn't it?
So Jed is right there in the quarterfinals. And finally, Brendon, with his 8-6 team, took down Jay's Array of Decay, who had a 10-4 record. But it turns out that a 10-4 record is no record at all, is it, Jay? That ain't no record. Nope, no record at all, is it, Jay? Because Brendon's Amanda Samuels revival is advancing to the quarterfinals.
You know what, Jay? It takes a real man to beat you. And guess what? I'm not even a fucking real man. I'm a fucking bunny wearing a fucking bunny suit. Still beat you.
Bunny!
Wait, what's on your...
Suck it, newbie. You have no idea what's coming next year.
Nice work, Brendon. That's great. Week 16, we'll see Joe and George face off and Alex and Jay face off in the consolation bracket. The quarterfinals will see besties Alan and Dave face off. Oh, who will win in that kissing matchup? And then Brendon will attempt to take out our only rookie left in the playoffs, Jed. Good luck, Brendon. We're all counting on you.
I just want to tell you both good luck. We're all counting on you.
In the toilet bowl, though, let's go back to that because we don't see that on the app. In the toilet bowl quarterfinals, we're going to see John's My Mom take on Todd's Off Tarks team again. Oh, wow. And then Brent's Doing Pretty Shitty is going to take on My Smelly Punt to see who's going to face off in the finals of the toilet bowl and hopefully get the first pick. That's about it. I know that the quarterfinals are already done, and we know who's going to the championship, but that video will come in a day or two. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you have a great night, and Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and guess what? Fuck you guys. Finley.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call.
Is it recording?
Yep.
Yeah.
Maybe take the cats into your fucking room.
Go ahead.
We get everybody?
Nope. Oh. Now we gotta get you.
Oh, okay.
Oh, well, how do you do you against you? Oh, you mean I'm...
Yeah, you may have beat me, but I'm still a winner in life.
Look where I am.
Yeah, look at me. My mahogany library and my leather-bound books.
I still have my mahogany library and leather-bound
books.
And you have a shitty win and a shitty fantasy league.
Yeah, exactly.
There you go.
Ash, recording. Get the fuck out of here. All right.
Hey, fuck you, Pete. Fuck you, Joe. That's a good ass whooping. Glad I fucking beat your ass. Even though I'm not going to make the playoffs, which, yeah, doesn't matter. I still beat you. So, fuck you. Go fuck yourself.
Whoa, slow it down. It's not like tequila.
Leave that in there.